everyone, so good to see you again. I'm Eran Stern, and this time we're going to see a cool way to slice time in Microsoft Word. So I double clicked on Word, but for some reason After Effects opened up, so you know what? We're going to use After Effects this time, and maybe in the future I'll show you the same thing in a Word processor. Anyway, I digress. Let's keep it short and sweet and start by selecting this clip that I got from Adobe Stock. Now, there is a link in the description if you want to download the same one and follow along. However, this method will work with any clip you have. Now, I already applied the Lumetri color effect to this clip and played with the basic correction sliders to make it more vivid and bright. So this is the before and after of this adjustment. And now I'll go to the effect menu, and under the distort category, I'll apply the wave warp effect. Now this effect will use a wave to distort a layer along an axis. And the way it does it is by creating time phases from different parts of the image. So we're going to take advantage of this feature and modify a few of the settings. I'll start by changing the wave type from a sine to a square. Feel free to play with the other shapes that you have over here. And then I'll change the wave width from 40 to 400. Next, I'll play with the direction over here, and I'll set it to 135. So this is what I want. And I'm also going to change the wave speed from 1 to 0.3. If I'll preview the clip, this is what we have, and it looks amazing, but we have this problem on the edges of the frame. And you can fix it easily by changing the pinning option from none to all edges. And this is going to take care of the problem. I'm also going to animate the wave height. So let's go to the beginning, set it to 0 over here, and create a keyframe. And over a course of, let's say, 1 second, I'm going to change it from 0 to 40. And let's preview again to see how this looks. And this is the main thing that I'm trying to achieve. So this is the effect. However, I think that we can make it even better by adding some border to differentiate those slices. And to do this, I'm going to go to the layer menu after making sure nothing is selected in the timeline, and I'll create a new solid. I'll name this solid lines, and to this solid, under effect, generate, I'll add the gradient ramp effect. Then I'll return to the clip, select the wave warp effect, go to the edit menu and choose copy with property links. Next, I'll return to the lines solid layer and press Command or Control V to paste this effect. I can control everything from the original instance over here, and this is going to affect this copy. Just to show you, I'll return back to the layer, I'll modify the speed, and you can see that both of them are working together. All right, I'll undo the last operation, return to the lines layer, and let's add the find edges effect. This time I'm just going to hunt for it from the Video Copilot FX console. And this is going to help us to find the edges. Of course, we need to invert the result. And then I'll also add a minimax effect. And this effect will replace each pixel with the minimum or maximum value in a certain radius. I'll set the radius here to 2. And of course, you can play with the ramp colors to modify the appearance of those lines. But I think this is going to look quite nice if I change the blending mode of the layer from normal to add or screen, it's going to show up like this. I'm going to go to the beginning and preview again the result. And I'm also going to click on the shy icon, which is going to show us that we have another text here. So I'll grab the solid, place it underneath the text, and then enable the text. And to this text layer, I've applied 2 instances of the linear wipe effect, which helps to reveal and conceal the layer, and I've timed it to the same pace of the wave warp effect. And this is it. Again, I can return to the original instance of the wave warp effect, and I can modify the settings over here, and everything is going to update automatically. I'll return to the project panel, open up the final folder, and show you a few other instances, just so you'll see that this is not a one-trick pony. This works with different clips running at different time rate. So this is, in case you didn't know, Valerie Proxiva. And I have another copy over here for this Dilly Dancer. Let's just maximize it and play it full screen. So there you have it. An interesting, almost hypnotizing look, all based on the wave warp effect, which was introduced almost 30 years ago with the second version of After Effects. And still useful to these days. And if it was useful to you as well, please like and subscribe and start to slice time yourself. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you again soon.